welcome back to Sports Chat.
503.
All right. Welcome back, all the NFL fans out there. Today, unofficially sponsored by, today, officially.
Officially.
We can go official on this one. Officially sponsored by Ray Racing. Anybody who's out there who's a race fan, check out Ray Racing, Portland, Oregon.
Yep.
Okay, NFL. Who looked good for you, NFL?
Looking good to me was
week two,
the Jets. I like the Jets. It may be that the Pats just didn't play well, but I thought the Jets looked pretty good.
Did the Jets look good or did the Pats look bad?
Yeah, see, that's the thing. Like, Brady,
I thought the Jets looked pretty good.
Yeah, I thought they did too. Brady had like the big comments about how we just sucked in the second half. Well, teams that lose usually did suck. Yeah,
they were pretty good the first half, though. I saw some of the first half.
Yeah. Another team, the Raiders won. They had a good rushing game. Pulled Jason Campbell.
Cheers to the Raiders.
A little scary, but
I was cool with Gronkowski last year, though.
Yeah.
However you pronounce his name. I thought he won games for them down the stretch last year. I think they won two games at the end of the year.
Yeah. And then
we see a lot of Raiders at West Coast.
Yeah, a lot of Raiders. And then Houston. I remember at the beginning of the year I was saying Houston, they got a killer passing attack. Yeah.
Kind of the dark horse for you.
Yeah, they don't need a real big rushing game because, like, Indy doesn't have a big rushing game. They just need a little defense.
Yeah,
and
they got good D.
Unfortunately, they beat my Skins in overtime, which sucked. But Schaub, 497 passing yards.
Wow. They're not really your skin. They're just your pick for the Super Bowl.
Yeah,
not
just,
like,
right. Yeah, I didn't grow up loving the Skins or anything like that. Yeah.
You know, I thought Houston looked good. I'm not really that sold on the Skins. I thought there were some of the parts of them looked good, but I still think that pick, you both your picks, I think, are ludicrous, insane, whatever you want to say. I don't see it with Washington. I hope, though. Great, that'd be good for them.
Yeah.
I'm impressed by Steelers. I'm a Steeler fan. I'm impressed by them just scoring with their defense, doing things with their defense, taking the pressure off their offense. Big Dennis Dixon fan. We know what it's like to have Dennis Dixon and a knee injury in the same sentence.
Yeah.
Jesus. But you know, it is what it is. So, we'll just go with it. And
who else do you like?
I don't know. I like the Pack, and I don't. That's about it. I like the Packers, and I think that Miami looked pretty good. But man, I'm really disappointed with the whole Carolina thing. Big Jonathan Stewart fan. Thought they could at least run the ball. I mean, they're getting blown. And the Cowboys, man, could be the national disappointment right now.
Yeah.
Cowboys is ugly right now.
Yeah, you know there's a lot of heads rolling down in Dallas, even after two games.
But you know what? Like you were saying right before we came on, you know, amazingly, we do actually talk a little bit before we come on. We don't just, like, hit play.
Yeah, we're friends. You know, we...
It's not just a contract.
Yeah, it's not just business. It's personal.
But, yeah, I mean, what does it say that Tampa Bay is 2-0? What does it say that Dallas is 0-2?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it doesn't mean a whole lot because nobody's picking Tampa to win the Super Bowl because they're 2-0.
But really, was anybody serious about the Cowboys going to the Super Bowl?
Yeah.
Everybody's like, oh, Dallas going to the Super Bowl because they're hosting it. Well, no, they're not. They're hosting it. Yeah, they might go in the press box.
Yeah, exactly.
Or in the luxury box.
Yeah, they might get some free field passes or something. But yeah, I don't think so. And I think after losing T.O., they wanted to make a big statement by saying, you know, we're going to be better without him,
I still think they haven't lost. I mean, or they haven't gained since T.O. Tony Romo missing the field goal. I swear, that's going to go down as one of those plays.
Yeah.
It just curses somebody.
Curses the franchise.
Yeah, they were ready to go that year, I thought. the other thing I think is kind of interesting is the Pats and the Ravens. Okay, so as AFC, I'm not really into the NFC. Sorry if that's any offense to anybody out there.
It's okay, you offend a lot of people.
Yeah, we got Monday Night Football tonight, and you were thinking maybe that the Niners could do okay, and the Niners looked terrible week one. So they might come out tonight, but they're playing the freaking Saints. Yeah, exactly. But I just thought that the Ravens and the Pats, those were two teams that, you know, going into the season, I thought the Steelers were gonna have a really tough time with. I thought they lost, or they split last year, or they lost both games. They might have lost both games to the Ravens last year. Either way, they didn't very, very well against the Ravens last year. And I thought maybe that the Pats would get them this year. And I think that the Steelers could come out right now and beat both those teams.
Yeah.
I think that the Ravens game might be 3-3, but, you know, I think they could do it.
Yeah, not bad. I thought Philly did okay. Vic did pretty well. He did what they need him to do, which is not turn the ball over.
Do people want to root for Vic?
I think they do. I mean,
I think so too.
And it's crazy because I thought that once Cole went down, if Vic, you know, held it together, they might consider keeping him in that spot. But no, they decided right after the game that Cole's the leader.
I think they have to, though.
Yeah,
think,
that's I mean, part of the
because
job.
Of the whole... Yeah.
Can't jump ship that early.
Well, especially because of the whole... We got rid of Donovan, and, I mean, I think people would jump ship.
Yeah.
Now, what about Vic and the dog fighting? Is he past all that? Do you think that people... Are people still holding it against him, that they don't want to like him because of that, or they don't want to...
I think it's fading fast. I think people's
memory... I think
memory,
so, too, man.
I think people's memory is getting shorter and shorter. They're
especially
not,
if he makes plays.
Yeah, especially if you're a winner, they tend to forget anything bad.
That's pretty interesting.
Yeah, it is, because I never thought... I thought there would be people calling for his head if he ever played another snap, and
okay.
You have people pulling for him.
So. Okay, so... Everybody's favorite topic. What the hell's going on, Brett Favre?
Brett Favre did it.
He's like one syllable, that name, Brett Favre.
Yeah, Favre. It's like that should be
back
like
to Brett Favre. That's like what year? What year did he go back in
that
time
be
to?
Like, Favre should be like Munson, where it's like you know, he pulled a Munson. It's like he pulled a Favre.
What year though would that go back to? Was it would it be 2 years ago? The year he was in the Jets? Did that look like?
Yeah.
Was it the year that he was in his last year at Green Bay where they went and they lost in the conference finals?
Yeah.
Was it, I mean, what? Because to me, reminiscent Favre is. Doing everything that a quarterback should not do, and then nobody having the balls to say, hey, Brett, why did you do that?
Yeah.
Why did you fumble in the end zone? Why did you throw when the guy was obviously going to intercept the ball?
Yeah, he's by far the oldest player in football, and yet he acts like he's a rookie still throwing.
Nobody will call the guy out.
No, he'll pull it off sometimes, but... Then there are games like against Miami where he throws three picks, and basically that's the difference in the game. And,
I mean, if I was Tavares Jackson or Sage Rosenfels, and I think out of anybody, every single person knows those two names.
Yeah.
Who else can name one backup in the NFL? Just one. Who's Denver's backup besides Tim Tebow?
Yeah.
Well, you might know it because he had some success someplace in college, maybe.
Yeah.
But the ideology is that we don't know backups. Everybody knows those two backups because Brett Favre.
Yeah.
Now, that's got to be the worst job. Because Brett Favre, you know, could do anything. He could go out and shoot heroin on the field.
Yeah.
He could go out and, like, you know, go Tiger Woods and have, like, sex with a waitress on the field, 50-yard line.
Or a bunch of them.
Or a bunch of them, one after the other. He could have... A wild orgy on the middle of the field, and nobody would be like, so Brett, what do you think about Chicago next week?
Yeah, like, you want to put your pants on real quick, or no, you're good for the interview?
So Brett, what about that defense? What kind of things were they showing you?
Yeah, exactly. He's like, you mind if
what were you seeing out there?
Yeah, I want to finish up here, and I'll field any questions y'all got.
I mean, Brett, I'm serious. I'm not like that big of a hater. I don't really care. I actually like him. I think he's great. I mean, whatever. Any guy would actually, in their actual heart of hearts, be like, I would love to be Brett Favre.
Yeah, for
because,
a day,
one, nobody's going to fire you. You will never actually get fired. You might want to leave because they piss you off. I'm out of here. But they're not going to fire you.
Nah. Yeah,
I mean, straight up. And so, like, if you're Sage Rosenfels, you could go out and have the best week of practice ever.
Yeah.
Knowing that no matter what Brett Favre does, it could be 0-11 going into week 12. This week, Brett's going to do it. He just needs a little bit of time to warm up.
Yeah. Yeah, he might be actually the last of an era for starting QBs like nowadays.
Roethlisberger is kind of like Brett Favre.
Yeah, but.
Roethlisberger has some Brett Favre.
Like nowadays, if you're a QB in the NFL, starting QB, and there's maybe like two or three that you can point out to where they're not going to get pulled no matter what during the game.
Look at the whole league.
Yeah.
These guys are in and out.
Exactly. Now, even if you're the starting quarterback, basically everybody's susceptible to getting yanked if they're having. Part of the game not going well.
Oh yeah.
You know, except for like Favre, Brady, probably Peyton Manning. You know,
Manning
never
is pretty
pulled.
Much the dude.
So
Brady is the dude, but Brady's the dude because he has the coach and he's got the history.
Yeah.
I bet Breeze is now because of where Breeze is at.
Yeah,
I bet
Breeze
he's
could
in that,
also.
I bet
yeah,
he's in that category.
He stepped up there.
And I bet the guy Rivers.
Yeah.
But even like Romo.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
They're
going to sign Quincy Carter any day now, I know.
Oh, Quincy Carter. Oh, my God. Okay, say a guy.
He's still got braces, by the way, too.
Wow. Okay, say a guy like Bradford comes out. Everybody wants to think that Bradford's a great quarterback, right? Well, I personally think this guy from Stanford named Andrew Luck is going to be the next big one. I think he has everything written all over him. Yeah. I don't think Jake Locker is anything.
4 for 20.
Terrible. But I think this Luck is for real, okay? Yeah. If he was the number one pick and Dallas had the number one pick, would they take him over Tony Romo right now?
I could see him doing it, you know.
In week two, they would.
Yeah.
But say that the Dallas goes out the season, say they finish, whatever, 8-8, whatever.
Yeah. Or even if they make the playoffs but lose the first game.
Sure.
I could see him, I could see him switching it up. I could see him saying,
I've never thought that Romo is top tier.
Yeah.
Never.
Yeah, me neither.
Is he? Besides the Dallas Cowboy, would he be the same guy if he was in Tampa?
No, he would have been pulled.
Not even close.
Yeah.
He would have been gone.
Yeah.
Because he's a Cowboy.
Yeah.
Oh, he's a Cowboy. That makes a difference. That doesn't make no difference. Yeah. Sorry, Cowboys fans, it doesn't.
Yeah.
Because the Cowboys really have not been that good for quite some time now.
Yeah, it's a pretty good... Pretty good marketing campaign Jerry Jones has got down there to keep everybody thinking that the Cowboys are...
That
are
stadium?
Yeah.
Jeez.
Yeah. But, it's tough, man. I don't know.
Okay, so real quick, are you still good with your picks?
I'm still good with them.
You're still locked in?
Especially since Tampa's 2-0, gives proof that even if the Niners lose this week, there's still hope.
I don't even know who I picked. I'm not really into the picking and going through the prognostication. Yeah. You know, to me that's like saying you want to do something on a Monday. Friday, and then all week goes on, you're like, I don't really want to do that. And then by Friday, you're like trying to figure out a way to not do it.
Yeah.
That's what I feel like about picking games. Yeah. I'm always like, oh, that'd be fun.
You know, it is.
I don't care about next week's games today. It's Monday. I don't give a damn. I actually look to see who's playing like on Sunday, like the day of the game. I'm like, oh, all right. Ooh, Jacksonville and whatever.
It's tough though, because if you'll go back and look at some of our videos for March Madness, we got Johnny Brackets.
Johnny Brackets, you were just on
so,
it, man.
It's just part of, ever since, I've never really been this way, but Johnny Brackets is,
he's
a picker now.
I think we should bring back Johnny Brackets for the NFL season and start seeing what your percentage is.
Yeah.
Start picking some games.
Yeah.
We'll put some money on the line. We'll get Ray Racing to finance, and we'll do this thing.
Yeah, good. Yeah, we'll do that. I like Jets and Skins. I like Niners and Raiders as sleepers.
Who is the worst team in the NFL right now? Is it still the Rams? Arizona?
That's
Cleveland, anybody?
I'd say
Who's the worst team?
I'd say the worst team is probably the Lions.
I forgot about the Lions. How could I?
Yeah, especially since Stafford's injured and out.
Oh, gotta be the Lions.
So.
Yep.
But you were gonna touch on the extra point, or you gonna do that another
minute? Yeah, what do you think about that? No, that timeout rule.
Timeout freezing
thing.
The kicker.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, they...
I don't like it.
Yeah, it's interesting because I like the way it worked against the Miami-Houston game, Washington-Houston. Even though Washington lost, they called a timeout on Washington when they kicked it, and he missed it.
Right.
And then they called a timeout, so he had to kick it again.
He made it.
Yeah, he kicked it, made it, but they'd call the timeout.
Right, right.
So then he kicked it again and missed it.
Right.
So then Houston gets the ball, and I'm sure they were thinking they're going to call a timeout to ice him.
Oh, exactly.
But they don't.
That was tricky.
And it didn't work.
And he totally made it.
Yeah, totally made it. So I kind of like it. It's just
I just don't like the up and down. I don't like the, like, woohoo, we won, yeah. What? No, we didn't?
Yeah, timeout, re-kick. Yeah, I totally agree with that part, but it would be hard to regulate. You know, it'd be tough to tell teams,
especially if it was the ender of a big one. NFC, AFC championship, somebody goes to the Super Bowl, that'd be big.
Yeah.
Yeah,
let us know what you think. If teams should be...
Agree to disagree.
If teams should be icing kickers at the end of games.
Is it a good rule or not?
Yeah, or should they just keep the pressure on and let them kick and have just the... Because also, it's like if you miss... You know, the first time, and they called the timeout, it's like you get a second chance.
Sure.
So you get...
It's your mulligan.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Well, I usually hit my first shot better. What about you?
Yeah, usually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, then I call the mulligan for no reason.
I don't hit them very well.
No. Sports Chat 503. Be good out there, buddy.
Peace.